Growing up in Cali, yeah, you know I love the weather. Limelight, hit 'em, and you know I handle pressure. I do what I want, so I'm never saying never. I get what I want, so they call me go-getter, yeah. I don't do it by the book, no, I do my own thing. That's why every single hook got 'em singing like me. And I ain't in any rush, 'cause I'm finally getting paid. Don't believe in any luck, I believe I'm self-made, yeah.
One and all, we are here to celebrate a historic night to honor two incredible influences who have paved their legacy across Southern California through tacks and barbed wire and light tubes, through literal blood, sweat, and tears. Within the world of professional wrestling, we admire and we respect the individuals who we see lay it all on the line in the ring. But tonight we are here to honor two people who have upped the ante and put their lives on the line. The impact of their influence can be felt not just in independent wrestling, but especially through the veins of pro wrestling's dangerous cousin, deathmatch wrestling. These two mentors, trailblazers, and entertainers, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Southern California Deathmatch Hall of Fame. Our first inductee's career began in 1996. He became a staple of extreme pro wrestling, staple, no pun intended, but you know, by winning the XPW King of the Deathmatch Championship. In 2001, he became XPW Heavyweight Champion, making him the only champion in the only dual champion in the company's history. He's a three-time CZW Heavyweight Champion and was inducted to the CZW Hall of Fame just at the beginning of this year. And although his last match took place in 2017, his influence can still be felt to this day. He is the Messiah. At this time, I would like you to join me in welcoming Joey Chaos, who will do the honor of the induction.
You know, I really want to thank everybody for coming out here to our show. Don't get mad, get even. The first ever inaugural Deathmatch Hall of Fame in Southern California. So, this first inductee, Messiah, you know, I first met Messiah back in XPW, and I must have been about 18 years old.
17,
yeah. And, you know, I would always, everything Messiah did, it burned my bubble, because I wanted to do everything he was doing. He was the XPW World Heavyweight Champion. He was the King of the Deathmatch Champion. And I would see him and I would watch him with envy in my eyes all the time and just see everything that he's doing and everything that he did. As I wanted to see myself do it. You know, because this guy was someone that I looked up to in XPW, because he was doing, man, he was tearing it up. And I tell all my students all the time, man, if you guys were here back in 2000, the landscape of professional wrestling, there was two guys. It was Supreme and Messiah.
Messiah!
And these guys,
Supreme!
And these guys, man, everybody looked up to them, including myself. With envy, I'd be in the popcorn match, opening match. Messiah and Supreme would be in the main event, in the deathmatch tournament, fighting for the heavyweight title. And so it's just always something. When I saw Messiah, I talked to him and I said, hey, you know, I want to recognize you guys. I want to recognize my people, the people that I came up with out here in Southern California, because you know what? I have had the opportunity to wrestle in a lot of places, but my heart and soul is right here in Southern California. When it's all said and done, and when they open the books and they look at Joey Chaos, at Southern California is kind of what I want to represent. And that's why I called up Messiah and I said to him, I said, hey, I want to do this inaugural Southern California Deathmatch main event. You know, and it would mean a lot to me to bring him here, to introduce him to the new fans here in Southern California. We have the people here that know who he is, and we got the new fans, and just gotta really remember, the guys that paved the way for us, those are the ones that we really want to respect. So without further ado, I want to introduce to you Southern California Deathmatch Hall of Fame inductee, the Messiah.
CZW Hall of Fame this year as well. And in all honesty, this is means way more to me than that did. More importantly, the reason it does is because Joey's doing it. So I guess it's good to have friends who own a company that can do this. But what I really want to say is I'm glad Supreme is finally getting his recognition. Because that guy, legitimately was the deathmatch guy in California. Yeah! And in all honesty, I never considered myself a deathmatch guy. I've only done a couple deathmatches and they were against him. And you're only as good as your partner. And I had a great partner in him. I also want to say, I think Dynamite D would be incredibly proud of you, Joey. Yeah. Yeah. XPW, Joey, Supreme, D, and myself, they dubbed us The Click. Because we always did stuff together. We're always together doing whatever. Where you saw one of us, you saw the other three. And I know that he's looking down right now, and he is smiling, and I mean, you're kicking ass. I am so proud of you, and thank you for this, and I apologize for dressing like this. Because he's dressed like that. And I'm... thank you. I really do appreciate it, and also I'm very happy that my daughter's here. Yeah. She's only seen me wrestle twice, and the last time she saw me wrestle was against Joey, and I think she was 5 or 6. So, thank you for coming here, being part of this with me, and Alex, your boyfriend's here, whatever. Thank you again for this. Thank you, Joey. Thank you to the boys in the back. You guys are killing it. You guys are kicking ass. Keep doing what you're doing. And again, thank you, and I'm very touched by it. Thank you, guys.
Winning the XPW King of the Deathmatch Championship, yeah! A title that he would go on to hold a total of 4 times by winning the company's first King of the Deathmatch tournament in 2000. He became a world travel competitor, touring Japan in 2000, 2003, leaving his mark on Mexico and all across the U.S. His brutality earned him the nickname the Human Horror Show.
Yeah!
Sage Sin Supreme and Kano Supreme.
It's been 5 years since either of us have been in the Santino ring, and we are incredibly honored to be here and to give such a prestigious award to an incredible man. I remember seeing Supreme at the XPW 10-year reunion show with Angel and Amanda, and I was in awe. And let's fast forward a little bit to when I was a ring announcer at Legion Championship Wrestling. This guy comes and gets me and says, Supreme wants to see you. First of all, I'm shitting my pants because I'm like, did I do something wrong? Holy shit, this is not good. But then I go backstage and I find out that he's happy and excited that I'm a deathmatch fan and he wants to share some of his knowledge with me. Later on, I get to become a valet alongside with Kano to him. That was an honor. And then fast forward a little bit more, with Apple, of course, Supreme is sharing boundless knowledge with us all the time. And we just get to learn all of his stories and hear so many wonderful stories from around the world from him. So that was just amazing throughout, you know, the years of learning from him. So, and I finally become a professional wrestler and I get to capture my first championship. I'm honored that he asked me to display my championship alongside his NGX Tag Champion and the notorious XPW King of the Deathmatch Championship title, and of course, all his trophies. honored. Supreme would do about anything for the ones that he loves. He would defend them inside and outside the ring, us included, truly having a heart of gold. When he bestowed his name upon me, I instantly became part of his family, became his daughter, and was beyond proud to carry out part of his legacy. So many people are influenced by this man, fans and wrestlers alike. So tonight, we honor him. Who is he?
Supreme!
In his wrestling career, my entire life, I have seen him bloodied and broken so many times in so many different ways. But I was never afraid. No, despite the grievous injuries and the insane spectacles he put on, no, I wasn't afraid. I was inspired. He inspired me to fight on. Always. He inspired me to never give up, to pursue victory at any cost, against any opponent. Wrestling impacted his personality on a supreme level. He has been a pillar of strength and perseverance my entire life. He's kind, he's caring, he would do anything for the ones he loves. And he's infinitely wise in everything he says and does. So I am beyond honored to be able to bestow upon him this wonderful award. All thanks to Santino Brothers Wrestling and SoCal for making this happen. I love you, Supreme!
All very much. Thanks, Santinos. Thank you, Joey. Love you. I gotta slow down. I also got this ring. First and foremost, I was always a wrestler. But deathmatch was my passion. I loved it. And every time I went out there to perform, put my body on the line, I did it for all of you, for the fans. Like, what would you want to see? What would I want to see someone do? So I did some crazy shit. I've been put on fire, I went through tables, I went through God knows, ladders, however high, I did all this for you. Because I didn't get paid that much. And to get this, through Santino's, thank you again. This is the most awesome thing in my wrestling career so far. It's been a long, long, long road. It's not over. Didn't retire yet. I didn't prepare anything. I didn't know I was going to get choked up because I was like, man, fuck it, I'm going to just go wing it. It's not as easy when you're choked up. This is an awesome company. Great wrestling so far today. And I'm here to announce on Halloween night, Santino Brothers will bring back the death match to Santino's. And who knows? Maybe I'll be up for it, and maybe I could join in some little death match stuff. Not one more. There's a lot more death left in me. My health has been bad over the years. It gets worse. It gets whatever. Now I'm feeling good. And I'm ready to do whatever it takes to please the fans, please the promoters, do what I gotta do to make wrestling what I think good. Indie wrestling is fucking awesome. You don't know how lucky you are to be able to come to a show and see the talent that you see here and other local shows. Indie wrestling is where it's fucking at. Yeah. I dig it, love it, because it's all groovy, baby. Yeah. Who am I? Supreme! Thank you very much. I love you all. I do it all for all of you. Thank you.